Yeah. Hey, Captain Blush.
I need a back, I'm hyperventilating.
This today, my friends, this is something that we've been waiting for months. And I will show you what it is. The ultimate. Salute first Reinhold and Sabine while you still have your senses. But don't worry, Captain Blush, it'll be great,
Well, it feels like the first time with a woman,
Yeah, of course it does, because it is the first time for such sexy plane, and not just that.
Because the last time I was flying the ultimate plane, we know how it ended.
Yeah, that was nothing, my friends, Check the video of the first ultimate.
And today we will have two tests, actually, We will test the Blue Hawk. Sexy, beautiful plane that came from Germany as a gift, and the plane was brought here by our dear friend.
Salute, Hubert, brother Hubert.
Thank you that you have gone all the way to the German border to pick this up and then bring it all the way to Slovenia to us, As I was saying,
The wingspan?
I don't know.
Well, this is the Bosa plane.
1.5.
Yeah, it should be something like 1.4 meter wingspan, but the point today.
Actually, it's 1.5. 1.5. The meter is 1 meter length.
Yeah.
Yeah, 1.4. 1.4.
Something like that, but the point is in this, and tell us quick.
Well, the engine is Magnum 15cc, 4-stroke.
This is what we are waiting, 4-stroke.
Yes. What is this called? Now I'm so interested, I don't even know,
What?
The cover,
What the cover?
The capotage.
Yeah, the motor cover, what?
The cowling,
The cowling.
The cowling is missing because this is the home-built plane. And Reinhold couldn't get one to fit. So you're going to ask, why this so much weight? What?
Yeah, this is scratch-built plane or what?
I think that he
not some
this.
Kit version or something.
I don't know, or kit, or, but who cares, now, because I don't even know what I'm talking about.
But enough of that.
You're going
quiet,
to ask, why is there so much lead in front? You could use the bigger engine, yes, you could. But if the cowling would be on, you wouldn't even see it. You could put 20cc engine on, but I have seen the video of Reinhold flying this and the motor is good enough.
Yeah, that is why he have put it on
because
so much
actually,
weight to get the CG.
This engine was originally on the Lazy B.
Yo, salute Lazy B. Because Lazy B has donated its engine after 20 years, so this plane can be in the air roaring. And that one is now living on forever and ever in our hangars on 4-cell batteries,
Yes.
Now, they are related. Can you imagine this,
And now,
some distant cousins,
And now for the second test.
This and this today, you must show
this. I have taken off all the old stickers and I have put it on new ones, which I will be testing today, a radio link. And this sticker is from that 17cc engine that will go on the Tucano.
Ah, of course,
Yeah. No, this is some still places to some stick someone. Look at this. How have I, from the cardboard box, look what I have done. See this?
But look at this.
You can take it off, but it is a tight fit because I have a belt sander at home, so I have just belted it, sanded it out.
And now it's inside.
So look at this.
Look at this idea for the radio. And of course, Captain Blush, like you were saying, this will be the first time that you will test the radio link.
Radio link 8010, which is actually 12 channel radio. And inside is a
And for that radio, you will have the link below, viewers. And this will be the test, because Captain Blush always loves his radios to be simple and sexy.
And I like them not OpenTX. So excuse me, I know a lot of you guys like OpenTX, but it's just, I don't know.
Well, this one can store 12 planes.
I'm an old-fashioned guy, so
for the next 12 planes, you're
16.
Good. You're good to go for the next 16 planes.
Yes.
Yeah, but the 12-channel radio. Yes, like
yes.
this.
And I have already bought some. This is fresh bought in Slovenia.
Yeah.
I bought this here. This Robert ordered with the transmitter.
Yeah, extra one.
Original is 12-channel. I'm just postponing today.
You're postponing this? I can see you, Captain Blush. Now, I can understand you, viewers. Because you must see, the maiden flights are always So thrilling, Kay. I really love them because on the maiden flight you don't know what will happen. You can fly or you can crash because this is the first time that you're in the air with the plane and you don't know if you have set it good. But let's hope, eh? I really wish you the best, Captain Blasche, to be this one perfect flight, eh?
As I said, we will do some how-to with this radio soon. Aha! Just
should I tell you something, Captain Blasche?
What?
I have pushed the on-off button, eh?
No, you didn't.
I wanted to take the picture.
No, you didn't.
Hey, you crazy man. Aha, oh. Oh, this fits inside, or what?
Originally came with the 8 AA batteries.
Yeah.
And I have bought on this store, Lipo.si, this.
Ah, the 3S.
3S.
It supports the 3S.
Yes,
because usually you have the
2S. From 7.2 to 15 volts says in the transmitter.
Yeah, but this is amazing, Kay. Because usually you do need to have the 2-cell batteries for...
Graupner and Futaba are originally on 8 AA batteries, which means 12 volts.
Oh, this is amazing,
so
Captain Blasche.
3S inside. Well, that's
another good information, say.
Yes.
Now, have you fueled the plane?
I have fueled it because I was waiting for you.
Ah, okay. But this will be something, eh? Look. Look at this sexiness, eh? Yeah, if this will fly as good as my Ultimate from the E-Flight flies, this is unbelievable, because the Ultimate planes are really, really great. Now, I don't think that
you... can see that I'm nervous because I was searching for
this. Yeah, I know that you're nervous, Captain Blasche. Eh? Yeah, I would be too, but don't worry, it will be okay. It will be great, hey.
Wait. No. I have already... Ultimate is the model, user is Blush. 5 minutes.
Acrobatic.
5 minutes on the timer.
5 minutes of pure fun, eh?
I have to say, this radio is really easy to set. I didn't look at any video on the YouTube because...
You can imagine this. For this one, you don't need to check 100 videos on YouTube to set it, eh?
Because it's easy. Now, the battery is in, the fuel is inside. I will prime the engine first.
You have the on-off switch?
Yes.
Ah, you have turned the radio on.
Yeah. And I have triple rates. I just have to remember where. Aha, here. No, this is not it. Which one is then, eh?
Yeah, I don't know.
Aha. Nah, this is the same button. Where did I put double rates, eh? No, I forgot, eh?
You have lost the button, say.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, yeah, but this is amazing, eh?
I didn't do anything on the ailerons because they weren't going so far anyway.
I can see that you have just what, on the rudder?
Yes. Where is it again?
Yeah. You have on the runner and the elevator.
And I have...
Yeah, but be careful, because you do have the 4 ailerons, Captain Blasche. You have 4 of them, eh? Show me the travel, the full travel. It's okay.
Yes, now I remembered, because I'm...
Did you set yourself some expo or what?
Yes, 30% expo on all surfaces.
That's it,
positions.
Good enough, eh?
Throttle cut.
Is it working?
Of course. I've done it all, eh?
Hey. No, suck some fuel in the carburetor, eh? Because we want to hear... We want to hear... What is it? Is it counting already? Do you have the timer?
What is this? Aha, nothing.
Okay.
Just some knob. Yeah, I have the counter now.
How does it work? When you put the throttle or what?
When I put 5% throttle on, it starts to
perfect,
count.
Perfect, like the Spectrum.
Whenever I take it off...
Yes. Yeah, this is how I like it on Spectrum. Yes, Captain Blasche.
Now, to prime the engine, you have a choke here.
Oh.
You don't have to stick your fingers in, eh? I'll give full throttle. And prime it.
Yeah, I can already hear the four-stroke.
As we said, four-stroke engines must be primed very good. The fuel must come out from all over the engine.
Yeah, I can see that it's coming from the exhaust.
Yes.
So this is it.
Throttle back.
I will grab it a little. I will grab the plane for you, Captain Blasche.
Yes.
Just in case.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh.
It's on green.
But this is unbelievable.
Yeah, I have a throttle on minimum.
Yeah, but look how sexy it works, eh? This is unbelievable, eh?
grab it firmly.
I'm grabbing it good.
Yeah.
The power is so sick and it really pulls good, eh?
Oh, do it.
Yo, Captain Blush, eh?
Wish me good luck, eh?
Hey, the best luck ever. I will go to my spot. To my spot. This is really nervous for Captain Blush. I know it even more because this is a gift. So, Sabine and Reinhold, sorry, eh?
Yo!
Something can happen.
Damn holes!
Yeah, hey, the moles are awake. Oh, the smoke. Good luck! Take your time.
Oh, now I have fun again.
Take your time. Trim it really good.
It's so touchy, eh?
Ah, too much ailerons.
Oh, but I will handle it, eh?
Hey, you can handle the truth, eh?
On this flight, I will not risk anything because I will have to change the travel, say.
What, you have two big travels?
Yes.
Even on the small rates?
As I said, I didn't do anything on the aileron.
Yeah, I don't know why. Well, fly sexy.
So for now, I will not do any stunts.
No, today no.
This is an aerobatic plane. Oh, it turns so good.
Because it is aerobatic, you won't do any stunts, eh?
No, because I have to get low.
And now I will be totally quiet, Captain Blush, and just enjoy.
I will do a long flyby.
I will just enjoy 5 minutes of flight and the sound of four stroke.
Fly by.
Yeah, but this is unbelievable how sexy it sounds, eh?
Fast fly by?
Hey, do it one, but be careful. Don't do it too close to the ground. Yeah. Hey, perfect enough, because the camera was not blurring, so it was great, Captain Blush, at least for once, eh? Hey, you're so lucky, even the camera loves you more than me.
You know what I have found out, eh? Hey,
no blurring today.
You know what I have found out? It flies better and faster, eh?
Yeah, hey. Woo! Don't be too comfortable too quick, eh?
That's enough for today, eh?
You didn't set no travels to the ailerons, Captain Blush. Leave something for the second flight.
One minute. Oh, left.
But I have tested this in the workshop and I was turning the engine for 10 minutes and it didn't suck nothing, yeah.
And this will be my best filming ever, eh?
I hope so. Now,
I didn't lose it for a second.
Another low flyby and then I will land because my thing
okay.
is wobbly. And now for the landing.
From that
side? I could go for one more, but...
that side?
Yes.
Ah, that is your favorite side. From the other side. Yeah. Little speed. Hey, finally I can smile, hey! Hey, to tell you the truth, Captain Blanche, hey! Go to the plane! Hey, to tell you the truth, today I was nervous, hey, as much as you, believe me, hey! Really, really I was, hey!
Look how good it idles, hey!
I'm zooming on the engine, hey, how it purrs! Hey, it purrs like a kitten, huh?
The cut?
Yes! Huh? If you could see viewers, I'm saluting Captain Blanche right now. Salute!
Salute Reinhold, hey.
Hey, and Sabina and Hubert.
That was something.
Hey, you have done it perfect, huh?
Now, let's go to the table. Eh?
Will you bring the plane back?
Yes, and I will explain.
Yeah, you can at least, you know, do you see the fuel tank?
No.
Aha, you can't. Well, we'll check later.
I have checked it before. When I had to disassemble the plane for the receiver installation, I have seen how much it sucked.
Yeah. So you will
and
see.
Usually, I know these engines. I had a few of these, and I don't know for 15 minutes of flying, 11 ounce, which is 3 deciliters.
So you use it, yeah.
About half of it.
Half of that. Yeah. But hey, nothing compares to the joy of this, to listen an engine like this.
No, as I said,
and of course we have seen that the radio is working perfect, huh?
The radio is looking perfect, eh?
Can you recommend it, Captain Blanche?
Of course I can recommend this, eh? It's very easy to set. The receivers are, I will say...
For a good price.
Not cheap and not expensive. Something in the middle, eh?
Perfect price for
here
the receiver,
say.
Here
in Slovenia, I can get a 12-channel receiver for $30.
Yeah, that is...
I can buy it somewhere else, but then I have to wait 2 months for it, eh? I have paid $18 for the... What's that? 8-channel receiver inside?
Yeah.
Yes, so pretty cheap. No,
this is amazing.
There.
Why?
We will film end the video or what?
Yeah, but I can film it rather here. If you go there, because it looks much better, so we can see the engine. No, just there.
Yeah,
like this.
No.
And now we can see the plane in all its glory. Eh?
As I said, it's an aerobatic plane. Eh? What? The transmitter?
Yeah, you can put it here.
Of course I can. Eh? I didn't want to put it because I wanted to show you the travels. Eh? Again,
uh-huh, the travels.
We have shown.
Yeah, but you have told me that you need to set the travels more, eh?
No more, less.
Yeah, you have to set them even because you didn't set nothing on the ailerons.
When I was preparing,
and you have the 4 ailerons, Captain Blanche.
Because I was preparing this in the workshop, it looked like, well,
yeah,
that wouldn't even be enough. So I didn't put any smaller ones. But actually, I will put half of this.
Half of this and it will be perfect.
And little less elevator. Because it was touch on the elevator. I was moving the stick, so small throws that it was sick, eh? Then I went, so when I have made the loop, you have seen the plane going like this because my fingers were all the way.
Yeah, but I think, Captain Blanche, that I have done you the justice and I was a good cameraman today.
It's
because I didn't lose I didn't lose a plane even, but it's so amazing, Captain Blush. It didn't blur even once. Maybe because of the fog again or what?
Because the sky is...
Oh, I don't know.
The sky is almost even, so the camera doesn't have to focus anywhere else.
I mean, this is amazing.
Yesterday when we were filming your plane, there was a sun here. Whenever you pass the sun, the camera blurred.
Yesterday it was beautiful, sexy, cloudless day, and we had the blurrings all the time. I mean, this is amazing. So maybe we will just film in the fog, eh?
Yeah, we will film only
and in the clouds.
Only in the fog, eh?
Yeah, but the planes even does look better in the fog and in the clouds, eh? But I will be quiet because today you are the star of this. Tell us something.
And this somehow, because Robert needs to do the maiden flight. So.
Oh, don't worry, you can talk, eh?
The assessment of this, what is this? Biplane category, eh?
Yeah, this you must give 10, Captain Blush, because it was a gift. Eh? For the gifts, you can't give less.
Why the camera on? Are you on the camera? What's this? Eh?
Okay. I will be quiet. Eh?
Hey, what's this? Pre-assessment or what? Eh? I wanted to give this 10, eh? But you have taken off my 10 because this is a gift.
Sorry, viewers, I didn't say nothing. Let's hear the Captain Blush. Eh?
It's balsa.
Yeah. Hey.
It is glow. It is four stroke. And
so
it flies sexy.
So anything less would be nothing, eh?
It would be unjust to put anything less than 10, eh? Not because it was a gift, but because it flies so good, eh?
And salute the Arthur Van Holst. Because Arthur, don't
from Netherlands, huh?
From Netherlands, Arthur, if you're watching this, I hope that you are. Don't worry, as long as we will have this channel, Patrinčič Brothers, and there will be Captain Blush, the balsa planes will not die on this channel, at least here not, eh? Because he's worried that at the end, with all these new foam planes and that technology, the balsa planes will die, but I don't think so, eh?
They will not die, and the glow will...
But look, there are wood all around, everywhere you look, there are trees, so we can cut something down and make a wood plane, eh?
And, because this will... Even glow will not die. Because there is a community on the Facebook page, Glow Nation, and it's getting bigger by the day.
Yeah, of course it is.
It proves that a lot of guys, I know the fuel is expensive, but at least once in a while you can take out from the workshop a glow plane and fly it.
But you can believe me, viewers, that even the foam lovers, they really want to see this world, and they also want to test a glow plane.
Yes, because
many foam plane lovers would love to have a plane like this.
These were the beginnings, eh?
Yeah.
And they are glow, they are diesel, which you mix your own fuel. They are...
You have now also on the petrol, simple petrol gas engines.
Back in the day, I have an engine at home, which was made in 1942.
Yeah.
It is... 1939.
Yeah.
It is Phil Gable from Germany.
Phil Gable, yeah.
Phil Gable, and it is petrol, 14.7 cc.
We hope to see that one running Sunday, Captain Blush.
Maybe, but it's historic, eh? So, okay. This is it, eh?
Now, yeah, you can give the assessment.
Today I can give the assessment, and I will give the assessment for the transmitter straight 10, because it is easy, it's not expensive, it's affordable, and you can do whatever you want with it, eh? Which is not whatever you want, it's not open.
This was one amazing Sunday morning. Because in fact, it's Sunday morning, we have time. Our kids are maybe still in the beds or watching cartoons.
Well, it's 8 p.m.
Salute our wives, because they are preparing the lunches.
Yes.
And that's it, eh, viewers.
Well, actually, today my mother-in-law is preparing the lunches.
Okay, yeah, but hey, it will be still perfect, eh?
Yes.
This is it. Don't wait nothing. Click on something. At least buy a second-hand balsa plane with the glow engine on, and believe me, it will be the peak of your life.
Cheap, eh?
Yeah.
Cheaper than foam planes.
Yeah, of course.
This is it. Pilot Robert and Captain Blush and Ultimate from Germany signing off from Slovenia in this fog, February day, Sunday, 8 a.m. Now cut.
Cut enough, Captain Blush.
Enough for today.
Viewers, we love you all and just expect more, because from now on, Captain Blush will prepare something.
Yes, because I got my mojo back, eh?
Yes, with this flight, he was postponing the flights because of signal problems and crashes and I don't know what. And now he's back in the winning streak, Captain Blush, huh?
Yes.
The lucky streak,
good set,
eh?
Good set.
Enough?
Cut quick.
Because you must do what? Nothing, eh?
I must film you now.
Yes. Viewers, thanks again, eh? And just expect more, eh?